riders are back in the saddle for the final six stages of this year's Tour of Italy. The first of these, number 16 overall, offers 226 kilometres and four classified climbs, including the highest point of the Tour, the Passo Gavia. Climbing starts from the word go, with the ascents of the Passo della Presolana and the Croce di Salven. Then it's north for a first trip through Ponte di Legno. The road continues on towards the Passo Gavia and the Passo del Mortirolo before a second visit to Vezza d'Orio and a short climb to the finish in Ponte di Legno.
Uh-oh, the pack is quickening the pace.
Counterattack by Giovanni Visconti.
There's some that just can't keep up. There are gaps beginning to appear at the rear. An attack is launched. Some team managers mustn't appreciate the fact that there is a breakaway, given that the pack has increased its speed. The gap is widening. It's now over 2 minutes. They're moving along at a fair lick. You've just got to hang on. The peloton has slowed right down. The teammates of those in the breakaway are not going to make an effort. It's up to the other teams to get their fingers out. A couple of teams have set themselves up as pacemakers for the pack. They obviously don't have anybody in the breakaway group. The peloton seems to want to wind the breakaway back in. Now they're riding, and the gap is melting away. The pack is increasing its work rate. Some teams can't be happy with the breakaway. This downhill will allow the riders to recover from their earlier efforts. The pace is really hot, so for the moment, we shouldn't see too many attacks. Oh my, the guys up front aren't going to be making too many friends today. The riders are in a portion above 10%. Look, the pack has taken its foot off the gas. The team leaders can't be too worried about the breakaway. The breakaway is not to everybody's liking. The peloton has significantly increased its speed. The pack is putting the squeeze on the breakaway. They really are moving. The pack can't get strung out too far, or it's going to start breaking up. He's off on his own. The team sponsor won't be disappointed. A rider is taking his chance alone. Some team managers mustn't appreciate the fact that there is a breakaway, given that the pack has increased its speed. The breakaway is not to everybody's liking. The peloton has significantly increased its speed. We're already at the halfway stage. A couple of teams have set themselves up as pacemakers for the pack. They obviously don't have anybody in the breakaway group. There's considerable daylight back to the peloton, and they don't seem to want to react. The pace seems much too high for many riders. The pack is increasing its work rate. Some teams can't be happy with the breakaway. It's in such percentages that the strongest can create some gaps. The gap is widening. The pack doesn't seem too concerned. Some team managers mustn't appreciate the fact that there is a breakaway, given that the pack has increased its speed.
Acceleration by Kelderman.
We're into the downhill section. The riders can take a breather, but they can't let their guard drop. We're into the last third of the race. We'll soon know the final outcome. That looks like a really bad fall. It's a shame, but he's not going any further. There's a report over the radio of a rider coming off his bike. But apparently, he's back in the saddle. A rider drops out. Now the guys up front are asking serious questions of the riders in the rear as more of them are left in the wake. The riders are going through a very tough portion with percentages above 10%. The distance has definitely widened. The breakaway is not to everybody's liking. The peloton has significantly increased its speed. This climb is feared by many riders. The percentages are very high. Falling behind! A team leader is falling behind!
Kelderman is off.
This climb features some dreadful percentages. The riders must be careful. This downhill is known to be very dangerous. The riders are entering the last 15 kilometers of the stage.
Attack by Bauke Mollema.
Ten kilometers to the finish line. Five kilometers remaining.
Attack by Bauke Mollema.
He dug deep inside himself to earn this victory. We're waiting for the tail-enders who continue to arrive. They're heading downhill, so they've got to make sure to keep warm and make no mistakes on their trajectory. And just in case you missed them, here are the race highlights. Thank you.